I've had a few people ask me recently how to set up triple monitors in iRacing. There were some changes iRacing made a couple of patches ago, and I think it's got people confused. It's very easy. We're just going to cover some in-game settings we need to change and some changes to .ini files. It shouldn't take more than a couple of minutes. First thing you want to do is go into iRacing, just load up a test session, and go into your options and graphics settings. In here, in monitors, I'd set it up as, well, if you've got three flat screens, set it up as three flat screens, or you can set it up as three curved screens and put in the radius of the curvature. I'll be honest, I have three curved screens, but I have it set at just three flat screens and I've just adjusted the FOV manually. I've just found that it works better that way, but play around with that. But most importantly, make sure you've got your full screen and the border unchecked. When it comes to this resolution, I've already set mine up in the NA file, so that's why it's showing this number. After you've set it up, never click on this. It'll reset the INI and then you have to start again. So just leave that as it is. Make sure you close down everything. Get it all completely shut down. Get back to desktop. Make sure no iRacing is running in the background or anything like that. Okay, once you're back at your Windows desktop, what you're then going to do is you're going to go into your Documents folder. You're going to scroll down until you see iRacing. You're going to open that. Now in here, there's this app.ini file. That is where you used to have to make these changes. iRacing, a couple of patches ago, amended how they do things. It's no longer in there. So a lot of people have been going in there trying to change it. They can't find it. They're getting all confused. What you need to do is you need to find these two files here. Renderer DX11 and Renderer DX11 Monitor. They're almost exactly the same. I'm not 100% sure, but I believe that one of these is if you're using the Windows app to launch the sessions, and one is if you're using the website. Basically, you're going to make the changes in both of them. You're just making identical changes. So you're going to open them in, I use Notepad. You're going to open them up, and there's loads of stuff in here. Once you get more into iRacing and playing around with files and stuff, you might find yourself coming here often and changing some things. Not all the settings that are available on in the user interface itself. So if you come down to display, this is where you're going to make your changes. Now, first of all, you need to know what resolution your monitors are. I'm using 1440p monitors, so my horizontal resolution, the width, is 2560 pixels wide. If you're using 1080 monitors, they'll be 1920 wide. The first thing you want to do is go into this window X position, and whatever your pixel width is, you want to put minus and then that figure. So as I said, I'm using 1440p, my width is 2560, so I'm putting minus 2560. If you're on 1920, you're going to be using if you're on 1080p, you're going to do minus 1920. If you're using ultra wides or some other, resolution or whatever, whatever your monitor width is in pixels, put that as the minus figure. The next one you're going to change is monitor width. Now, for monitor width, what you're going to put in there is 3 times whatever your pixels horizontal pixel number is. So for me with 1440p, it's 2560 times that by 3, and that gives me 7680. So that's the number I'm going to be putting in here. For 1080, it's 1920 times 3, 5760. That's what you're going to put in there. Then for monitor height, very simple, just 1080 for 1080p, or 1440 for 1440p, or if you're running 4K or whatever, just put ever what your monitor pixel height is in there. Now, as you come down, there are some other settings, including this full screen width, full screen height. I don't think you need to change this because we've already taken off the full screen option within iRacing settings. I did, however, put my full screen width and full screen height the same as I did up above. I don't think it's less necessary at all. So anyways, close that, make sure it saves it. I've not made any changes, so it hasn't saved. And then go into the DX11 monitor file, and you're going to do exactly the same thing. Go down to display and just make the same changes. So just to briefly recap, Windows X position at minus whatever your horizontal pixel is, and then monitor width is 3 times that same number, and window height is whether you're 1080, 1440 or whatever, you put that in there. And again, save that. After you've done that, we're going to go back into iRacing. Once you're back in iRacing, what I recommend you do is jump in the car and then just immediately exit back out of it, and then make sure that in the replay mode, you're sitting in the cockpit and you've got the cockpit cam set. This is where we're going to make tweaks to your FOV. Go into options, graphics, and monitors. Now, they've got this kind of calculator type system built into iRacing. This is a good starting point. For me personally, I've always found I need to then tweak it once I'm actually in the sim itself. But just put in your monitor width, your bezel width, and your viewing distance, and click compute. And that'll give you what it recommends. Now, what does it recommend for me? Okay, so it happens to recommend 150, which is what I'm running. So that works out well. Click done. Come back out here and you'll be back into this screen here. Now go back into test. You can adjust your FOV further once you're actually in here. Now where are we? Driving FOV. Now at the moment, so I've got it set at 150. I find that in the past I've often had to tweak this to get it quite right. And you might find it's totally different to what you've been running before and it looks really alien to you. It's worth going out and doing a couple of laps. Your brain will kind of readjust it. Anyways, I hope you found that helpful. If you do have any questions or any issues, please just drop them down in the comments. I'll be happy to help. If you want to, come and join us on Twitch. Stream there 2 or 3 times a week. And also, I'll be uploading some videos to YouTube, maybe some race highlights, some other tips and tutorials. Anyways, we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.